Good morning, afternoon, or evening. My name's Andy, and today we're going to be taking a dive into otter history.
In this video, we will learn why California sea otters still struggle with the history of human impacts, and small lifestyle changes that we can take to help California sea otters recover from these impacts. Our dive into history starts at the very beginning of recorded human history. Both California indigenous peoples and California sea otters helped to shape the kelp forest into a habitat that would benefit each other. Otters benefited human uses by eating sea urchins, which act as a pest in the kelp forest, and humans helped otters in many ways, including hunting animals that compete with otters for food. Sadly, this relationship was disrupted by a period of human history known as the California Fur Rush. At that time, people from all over the world, especially Europe and Asia, rushed to California in search of commercially valuable fur. Because they have the thickest fur of any mammal, sea otters became a popular choice for fur clothing. At that time, very few people would have thought about the long-term effects on the environment that their fashion choice would have. But as the 19th century drew to a close, it became obvious that otters were disappearing in much of their range, and in many places they were entirely gone, meaning they had become regionally extinct. It was at that time that several governments, including the United States, realized something had to be done to protect otters. Their solution was to pass a series of laws and treaties that would regulate the hunting of otters and help protect them against future overhunting. This would help California sea otters to begin to recover. But as I mentioned before, California sea otters are still struggling with a history of human impacts. One reason they continue to struggle with this human history is they haven't been able to return to all of the places they were once found. In many places where they were originally hunted to extinction, they remain a missing part of that ecosystem. My home county is one of these places where otters are no longer found. Another period of California history that otters continue to be impacted by is a period that started in the 1950s. We're still living in this period. Our time is defined by our use of plastics and oils. Much of our oil comes from the very places that otters call home. Thus, otters are at an abnormally high risk of impacts from oil production. When otters get into oil spills, like this little otter, they have a lot of very bad things that happen to them. They can lose their ability to regulate their body temperature. This can have some really bad long-term impacts on them. But they also run the risk of getting poisoned because all the animals within their ecosystem, like crabs and sea urchins, also are consuming oil from the water. When it gets into the otter's diet, it causes all sorts of problems. It can even lead to death. This otter was lucky enough to be rescued by California Fish and Wildlife. She was then nursed back to health and was released into Monterey Bay several months later. The past may have been very rough on the California sea otter, but we have the power to help shape the future of California sea otter history. By making small lifestyle changes, we're able to help otters on their road to recovery and to help create a brighter future where humans and otters can once more collaboratively work to protect kelp forests. Possibly the easiest thing we could do for California sea otters is simply use less electricity. By using less electricity, we reduce our need of oil and can help limit the amount of oil spills. Another simple thing we can do to help California sea otters is use less plastic. This too reduces our need of oil, but it also helps reduce the risk of ocean trash. It's important to remember that these are only some of the ways that we can help California sea otters in our daily life. In your Flipgrid response, record one idea for another way that you could help sea otters. Maybe it's something like recycling more, or some other unique creative solution. Thank you for watching, everyone. Remember that even though California sea otters are still struggling with impacts of human history, we have the power to change that by making small lifestyle changes.